Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Pokémon Colosseum. Last time we took on Lady Venus, the Cipher admin, and we caught her Suicune, which, jeez, we caught it in two Pokéballs, which I was not expecting to happen. And in this episode, we are going to be heading down here, because of course we're chasing after her. Now, I went into the right because, shortcut, I guess, because she goes down this elevator that you can only get to from the left. Unfortunately, there is no way to call that elevator back up. So we have to go down the stairs. What do the stairs have? A lot of trainers. Whoops, there were other spies. You're not getting past me. I think I might. Hunter Frina? Okay. And because we have all these spies, or these trainers, I should say, we are actually going to be catching more Shadow Pokemon. It had been a while since we caught anything up until, like, Ledian and Suicune, and now it's just going to be all out. We're going to be catching them for, like, the next couple episodes, I think, so... yeah, can't go wrong there. I'm glad we're getting back to catching stuff. So I guess it's a good job that I restocked on all those Pokeballs. Anyway, let's see. Let's Psybeam the Shroomish, and we shall slash on Jigglypuff. We're actually kind of over-leveled for these trainers. We weren't over-leveled for Venus by any stretch, but... yeah, these trainers are a little lower. That did not take out Shroomish. I was actually gonna go for Surf, but I should have probably gone for Surf because those two both lived. Okay, and now he's using Growth. Not that he's really gonna get to do it because Nico's probably gonna just take him out next time. And Torpedo Tears, special defense fell, should be fine. And that was only on Nico as well. Let's Swift and Surf, because Swift is probably gonna take them both out. I would hope so, because they're both really low. There goes Shroomish. And once she sends out her next Pokemon... oh god, wait. Wait. Oh god, this could be really bad, actually. Let's see what happens. I know what's coming out. And Joey's about to use Surf. I may have made a big mistake. Teddy Ursa. Which is fine, I don't care about that. And Gligar. It's level 43, though. That is our Shadow Pokemon. Please don't kill it, Joey. Please. Oh, that's Teddy Ursa first. Alright, that thing's like half health. Please don't kill it. Super effective. Okay, good. I honestly thought that that thing was gonna die. So, Gligar, a ground flying type. Two very contradictory types, I guess. Like, they're the opposites of each other. One's in the air and one's on the ground, quite simply. That typing is unique in the fact that it gives it a unique resistance to, well, ground, because of flying, and also electric. So the ground counteracts flying's weakness to the electric type. Only problem is, with it, it doesn't evolve. So in later games, it actually gains an evolution in the form of Gliscor. However, it's not in this game, and the only real good thing about it, I guess, is that it does get some somewhat decent moves. For example, Slash, which not many Pokemon get, and we just got it on our first ball. I'm okay with that. But that's Gligar for you. We caught it before the bio even ended. But, yeah. That's all I really have to say about Gligar, because if you want to pick it up and use it, do? Because, I mean, it's not terrible. It's no Ledian. But it doesn't evolve, and I feel like it really lacks potential until it does. But it doesn't do that in this game, so... no, I'm not supposed to lose. I've won a Colosseum challenge! With a Teddy Ursa, a Shroomish, and a Jigglypuff? If you say so. And a Gligar, I guess. I bet the Gligar carried her. If you're mean to me, I'm gonna cry, okay? Yes or no? Yes. Why? What happens if we say no? But I want to cry. Okay. Anyways, I was about to say scrolling on down. Strolling on down, we have yet another trainer. What the? What's this little boy and girl doing all the way down here? What's Frina doing up there, up top? Crying, actually. Chaser Lyax? These people don't have real names, as I pointed out at the beginning. Yeah, you got used to the first guy. His name was Willy. And then after that, that was like the last original name, or last human name you saw. But anyway, Nico and Joey are probably actually the perfect fit here, because we can Psybeam the Gloom and bite the Curlia, and that should hopefully take them both out, because that should both be super effective. Down goes Gloom. I pointed out how much I like Gloom's model in these games, like last episode or something. Episode level 43. I really gotta stop using Nico and Joey because they're gonna start just pulling ahead of everybody else, and I don't really want them to be too much more overpowered. We're gonna bite. Gonna take it down? That's gonna take down Curlia. Jeez. I mean, I'm not complaining that these two are the most powerful on our team, but just chill out a little bit there, Joey and freaking Nico. I may switch them out because we have a Stantler, which is our Shadow Pokémon. A normal type, an interesting normal type. I believe it can actually get some psychic type moves, and it also has Intimidate. Normally, I'd say this thing is pretty mediocre. And even in this game, there are better normal types in the form of Forret, for example. It's actually a little better than Stantler in this case. I'm also going to switch out to Hedwig. But it does have Intimidate, like I mentioned, which is somewhat uncommon in Colosseum, so, and it can actually be really useful because, of course, in double battles, it's perfect because it lowers both the attack of both of your opponents. And then it also comes with Hypnosis in its starting moveset, which, of course, Hedwig has. And it's incredibly useful because you're catching a lot of Pokemon, being able to lower their attack and then put them to sleep, it's pretty useful. So if you want to use it for that, oh my god. I'm surprised Hedwig just lived that, and that did a lot of recoil damage. This may kill it though. Yeah, if you want to use it for that, I can recommend it, but at the same time, it's not the best, but it's better than it is in, say, Gold and Silver. Anyway, I am really hoping that Hedwig is a little faster than Stantler so that it doesn't die here. But Slash Roselia, oh, Joey's faster than Hedwig. Ah, I didn't take it out, didn't take it out. If we can just get off the hip, oh god, please go after Joey. Well, Hedwig died for nothing. That was fun. Let's send out Donovan then so we can at least get the paralysis. Go Donovan! Almost level 42 as well. Maybe they're not pulling quite as far ahead as I thought. This may take out Joey, actually. Crap. No, he lived. Okay. Let's see. We are going to Thunder Wave Stantler and get rid of this freaking Roselia with Joey. Joey may die this turn, depending on who Stantler targets and if it breaks through paralysis, but we'll see. Actually, it's probably faster than Donovan, because it's a reindeer and Donovan's a fat sheep, but we'll see. Wait, what's he trying to learn? Light screen. Psychic type. It creates a wall of light that lowers special attack damage, so we would have Reflect and Light Screen on the team if we did that. I think we're actually going to do that. Of course, we have mostly just electric type moves. I think we'll get rid of Thunder Shock because it's the weakest. So, yeah. Light Screen's actually going to be pretty good, and I believe that's one of the last moves Donovan's going to be getting, unless we teach it TMs. Oh, it's faster. Yep. Of course he goes after Joey to get rid of the bigger threat. The AI was actually smart for a change. Alright, Tyson, come on out. It's been a while since you've been in a fight. Okay, just get off this Thunder Wave. And of course Intimidate as well, which is very useful. Thunder Wave! And then we're gonna spend the next turn actually throwing balls at it, because I would like to catch this thing. And since it does a lot of recoil damage to itself with, actually, let's put up a light screen with, Words. Takedown, that seems to do the most. Yeah, let's just toss an Ultra Ball, why not? I was gonna use up our Pokeballs, but the Shadow Pokemon are kinda getting up there in the levels now, so I think we're gonna just start using Ultra Balls on everything, to be honest. Alright. One! Okay. Please don't be another Entei, Mr. Stantler. I really should have gone and saved between fights so that if we accidentally don't catch this thing, I don't have to also catch Gligar again. Oh, it's takedowning again. Oh, even to Donovan that did a fairly decent amount. Actually, it didn't do as much recoil that time. The only reason I'm not hitting this thing is because it's got Shadow Rush and Takedown, which both do damage to itself. I guess let's use... Actually, Rapid Spin might not do that much, but at the same time, I don't want to use an attack on it in case it accidentally kills itself. That only has a power of 20. I kind of want to use a rapid spin. Screw it, let's use a rapid spin. I mean, the ball is going to go first, but rapid spin's really weak, so I'm kind of hoping it's not going to do too incredibly much to this thing. I mean, again, it's level 43. 2, 3. Okay. It's going to be another Entei, isn't it? Where it's just going to freaking kill itself. Okay, that's good. That's good damage. Got it down into the yellow. There's the takedown again. It is not getting paralyzed at all. Like, I appreciate you using the Thunder Wave there, Donovan, but it's not really doing much. Okay. Let's toss another Ultra Ball. And then let's actually... Do we have anyone who needs healing? This is probably a waste. You know what, let's heal Donovan just because he's out on the field. I don't want him to die. Okay. Ultra Ball, go! Please just stay in the ball. Just stay in the ball, Stantler. Please. One. Okay. Maybe he doesn't like Ultra Balls, and it got fully paralyzed. Nice. In that case, let's see. What else do we have here? Water and Bug, weaker Pokemon. Let's throw a Timer Ball. Let's see if it's been long enough to where a Timer Ball would be effective. And I'm going to use Agility, because Tyson needs to be fast, apparently. All right, Stantler. Maybe you just don't like the design of the Ultra Ball. Maybe you'll like this one. One, two, three. Okay. This thing's gonna just keep using takedown and probably kill itself. Also, missed opportunity with the animation there. Like, Tyson could have quite easily spun around on his head, not just spun around in that awkward way right there. You're getting low on health there, Stantler. I'd appreciate it if you'd get in the ball. Maybe he likes great balls. You know what? I shouldn't use a great ball. I should just use the ultra because it's the most likely to catch it. And we're gonna use another agility. Okay. Please stay in the ball. One. Okay, after the next ball, I think I'm just going to start cutting to when we actually throw the balls at it, because otherwise it's just going to be this repetitive... Oh god, don't kill yourself. It's just going to be this... Jesus, this repetitive as crap thing, and one more Shadow Rush or Takedown, and this thing's going to kill itself. So, this is probably our last chance to catch this thing. If we don't catch it, I'm going to have to reset... And light screen wore off, okay. And then we'll also have to catch Gligar again. And all of our levels will have gone back down. I may have made a mistake. Okay. Nico, put up a Reflect. And Tyson, throw this Ultra Ball. Well, I guess it's not Tyson throwing it, but you know. Imagine if the Pokemon actually threw it. Like Tyson just spun around and like kicked it over there or something. Okay. Does this thing only have Shadow Rush and Takedown? No, I know it has Hypnosis. Three... Thank you, Stantler! Means we don't have to reset the game and catch Gligar again. I accept that, thank you. What's with this ridiculous power? You mean the power of my balls? Because that's how this match ended. Jeez, okay. I know why Freena... Oh, it's Freena, not Ferna. Freena? I think that's what I called it before. Freena up top let you two through. Oh, I get it. I got it real good. In that case, you won't mind if I go heal, right? Because our team's not looking too great. I think we need to heal them up a little bit. Welcome back. I'm also going to switch the team around a little bit, I think, because Nico and Joey kind of pulling ahead of the pack a little bit. I think we're going to go with Hedwig and Tyson because they're our two weakest, because I want to train them up a little bit more. And yeah, I know I don't have the experience share on anybody right now. I don't think we personally need it on anybody, to be honest, because everybody is kind of around the same level. Also, what is this? What are you? Oh, we have an item room. Oh, two timer balls. That makes up for the ones that we used. And what do we have over here? We have two max potions. I will take those. I mean, I wasn't going to buy any max potions, but I'll take any free ones that we get. Alright, moving on down, I believe we have one more trainer. Hello there. Well, what do you know? I hardly thought that I'd have to get involved in this. I like how it faded to black and like changed the complete the angle of that just for that one line. Also, your name is Lonia. And you have a Dunsparce and an Octillery. Two very unique Pokemon, as I think I've pointed out before. I have a Hedwig and a Tyson. I admit saying it that way makes it sound odd. But anyway, Intimidate's gonna lower both of their attacks. Okay, so Hedwig. I believe Octillery's part poison. Could be wrong on that, but it's Confusion Octillery, and we shall triple kick the Dunsparce. Please do a decent amount. Critical hit. That was not super effective, and a crit barely even did half. Okay, and Tyson missed. Of course Tyson missed. Ice Beam. Oh. Oh. Actually, that didn't do anything. I forgot Dunsparce has terrible stats, and you have Thunder Wave. Alright then. You're gonna paralyze Tyson. I see how it is. Well, if you're gonna spam that, you can go right to sleep, and you can get triple kicked, I think. Not if that misses, though. Stop spamming the Ice Beam, Dunsparce. You're not gonna do much, unless you get a crit, in which case that would suck. Focus Energy. Are you preparing for a triple kick, Octillery? Alright, please, Tyson. Okay. One, that didn't do much, but two is gonna do a little bit more, and if we get the third, I almost took it out. I can accept that. Okay, let's actually have Hedwig attack the Dunsparce, and we shall triple kick Octillery and see what that does. I'm hoping takedown will be enough. Should be. Yep, and we got a crit as well. Not that I think we needed it, but with an owl that size charging into your body at full speed, yeah, I think you'd faint. Alright, what else do you have? You have a Masquerain. Another pretty unique Pokemon. I like this trainer's odd set of Pokemon. Like, it's not stuff you really see all that often. You have Psybeam. That did nothing. Okay. Triple kick connect. Yes, okay. One. Two. We should get the third as well. Three times. Didn't do much, but it was enough. Okay. We're actually gonna fly this Masquerain, and I think we'll try for another triple kick on Octillery, because Tyson has broke through paralysis these last two turns. I think he should be able to do it again. Not if everything targets him and kills him, though. This might actually finish him off. Yep. I didn't even think that the Masquerain could have a psychic type move. Whoops. Okay, let's actually go out to Donovan, because if this doesn't kill the Octillery, it's gonna catch a Thunderbolt, I think. Because it's a bit of a pain. Actually, you know what? No, let's Thunderbolt the Masquerain, because Hedwig's already targeting. Actually, no. Hedwig's targeting the Masquerain, and that did nothing. Okay. Take it down. I hope. Yes. See, this is all it took. We just needed to switch out to Donovan for him to save the day. Alright, and I believe her final Pokemon is in fact a Piloswine, which, as Rui will let you know, is in fact a Shadow Pokemon. This is an Ice and Ground type, which again, pretty unique typing. Ice, unfortunately, is the least defensive type in the game. It has the most weaknesses out of any Pokemon type. The Ground typing does give it the immunity to Electric, though, which can be kind of useful, but it also adds an unfortunate weakness to water. But you know what? That I was gonna say something else positive, but I can't really think of anything else about this guy. In later generations, it does evolve. It's much like Gligar in that sense. It gets another evolution. And if it had that evolution in this game, I could recommend it. But it doesn't, so I kinda can't, to be honest. But I don't know, if you want to use it, you go right ahead. I'm not gonna stop you using a Piloswine, obviously. But just know that it's not a personal recommendation of mine. And again, it's not something I've ever used, so I don't know if I have all the authority to say that, but either way. Also, there is, spoiler alert, another ice type coming up right after this one, so I can actually recommend the one that's coming up over this guy, but you'll see that when we get to it. Also, that confusion did absolutely nothing to this Piloswine. So I'm gonna do a takedown and see what it does. I don't want to hit it with anything. Obviously, I can't hit it with anything electric because it's immune to electric. That didn't do much either. Actually, you know what? It's part ground type. I should really get Donovan out of here. And then again, the ice typing on it is probably not going to be too great for Hedwig. Let's see. Donovan, we'll switch you out to Joey. Because Joey can take hits. And I don't want to use a water type move on it, obviously, but we'll see what happens. Now, use takedown, Hedwig. And it's almost at half. Okay, this thing is defensive, apparently. And I love its little feet that you can see when it walks like that. And it woke up, not that you can tell. Oh, it's got Dig. In that case, you can fly. And you... Can we throw a ball at it when it's on the ground? Does that work? Does that really work? I think maybe we've had that happen before. No, that was when it was flying. It does work. You can throw Pokeballs at them when they're on the ground. I didn't know that. 2, 3. Ah, oh, Piloswine, I thought you were going to be nice. And then it just disappears. All right, well, Hedwig's out of harm's way. And there's the Dig. Okay, I can deal with that. That didn't do diddly squat. Okay. I am going to set up a rain dance just because I want to. I want to have it raining. Why not? We're waiting for Hedwig to do our attack anyway, so. Here comes the fly. That did nothing, but again, don't want to get it too low because of Shadow Rush. So, yep, there's the Shadow Rush. It's gonna lower its own health. After almost taking down Hedwig. She lived. She's good. And a light screen wore off that Donovan put up a little while ago. And the rain continues to fall, so it's gonna play this circling animation again. Alright. Hedwig, we're gonna switch you out to Nico because you're a little low on health. And Joey, we are gonna throw this Ultra Ball. Hopefully we can catch it. This thing got, what, 3 shakes on the last one? So, I'm hoping that is gonna happen again. Well, no, I'm hoping we're gonna get more than 3 shakes and we're gonna catch it, but... 1, 2, 3! Yeah, got it. Okay, we didn't even have to switch Hedwig out after all that. There we go. Bodybuilder Lonia has been defeated. I never, ever thought that I'd take a fall this easily. You could have been out of this match so long ago, but I wanted to catch your Piloswine from you, so... Yeah. I'm a loser! I can't show my face in front of Lady Venus like this! Well, just don't. You can just walk up this way and leave, if you really want to. Also, the reason I'm walking up here is because not only do I want to heal, I also want to check the PC so I can move the Pokemon around that we got. And we're also going to end the episode off, so I'm going to meet you by the PC. So this episode did actually end up running a little longer than I was expecting. I believe that's mostly because of Scantler. Like, he did not want to get in the ball, so... Episode was a little bit extended, but I'm sure it's fine. Anyway, with that is actually going to be it for this episode. I know that we only had 3 battles, but we did catch 3 Pokemon as well, so I feel like it evens out. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one where we should potentially be finding out where the heck Venus is. Also, this thing comes with a soft sand, so that's nice. Yeah, stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.